Some of you out there might be wondering why my hair looks stupider than normal. It's because I've been wearing a helmet. I've been wearing a helmet because I've spent the weekend driving this little thing. Chances are your grandparents will recognize this before you do. That's because they used to build these back in the 30s. This is a Morgan three-wheeler, and it's been updated for the 21st century. Saying it's updated for the 21st century is pushing it a little bit, to be totally honest. It's the same package that Morgan used to produce. Two steering wheels up front, a drive wheel in the back, an engine, a gearbox. What's updated though is that the motor is from S&S, and fans of Harley Davidson will recognize that name. The gearbox comes out of a Miata, and off of the gearbox is a drive belt that sends the power to the rear wheels. This is the S&S X Wedge. It's opened up to a larger degree than the normal S&S motor, which allows for bigger pistons and cylinder heads. And this is a 2-liter unit, which sends about 100 horsepower right to the rear wheel. So what's it like to actually drive this thing? Well, normally I'd put my mic on and tell you as I'm doing it, but I can't do that here because of wind noise, glorious wind noise. This is an open cockpit car, or motorcycle really, because that's how it's registered, and that's why I'm wearing this helmet. But none of that matters. What matters is how this thing drives, and spoiler, it drives amazingly. The steering is incredibly direct. The gearbox is from an MX-5 Miata, so you know that it's good. The pedals are placed nicely close so you can heel toe if you want to, and the whole affair is pure driving excitement distilled down. It's distilled down so far, they don't even need all four wheels. You just need three. There's no body roll in the corners. This thing just goes, and if you're not careful with the throttle, you will be spinning that back rear wheel as you leave the line. You're gonna get looks, but embrace them. Give the thumbs up back because everybody wants to know what you're driving. So just enjoy it, smile, get the bugs out of your teeth, keep some sunglasses on, and rule the road because you have the coolest vehicle within hundreds of square miles. I don't care what pulls up next to you, you're having more fun. Someone could show up in a Ferrari 458 and then think to themselves, man, my car's awesome, but dollars per fun, the Morgan wins. Yeah, it costs $50,000 to $60,000, which is expensive for a toy, but it's cheap for how much fun you have compared to other toys on the market in that price point. I love muscle cars, I love modern sports cars. If I had to choose, and I would be a crazy person, I'd take the Morgan three-wheeler all day, every day. Now, it can get a bit terrifying on the highways. I have a new respect for guys who ride motorcycles. I had hyper awareness when I was driving this on the 405. Cars that are normal size when you're in a car are now huge, and cars that are big are now gigantic. If I pull up next to your average crossover, I'm looking up at them. If I pull up next to an Expedition, all of a sudden that feels like a semi-truck, and semi-trucks feel like earth movers. It doesn't matter though, you drop a gear and you motor past them, smiling the entire time while they realize they wish they were having as much fun as you. I can't stress that enough. This is one of the most fun vehicles on the entire planet, and I think it's worth every single penny.